All right, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to DreamHack TV. One more time here, we've got Moon Meander. He was out there in the crowd watching this last match, and just wanted to get your thoughts here. Maybe your good buddy's thoughts here. Real quick, first question, who the heck is this?
That's my Strife pet. It's called Waini, which means I love you in Chinese.
Wow. Were you over there playing Strife?
It's a secret.
Okay. We can't talk about that. But we can talk about the game that was just going on right here. And, of course, you're watching because you're going to be playing the winner of this series tomorrow. So just going to be trying to get some information about that. Denial taking on Shit Happens right here. I mean, what were you thinking going into this match?
I was thinking anything can happen because Shit Happens happened to beat Panny's team and happened to beat Reason Gaming's team. No pun intended.
Yeah.
And so we were like, anything can happen. So I was just around and decided to pop by and see what's happening. And I actually thought that Shit Happens had a chance, get this decent chance to beat Denial.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of people were saying that they thought that they have a decent chance, and I mean, they still have definitely chances to take a map or even the series if they come back 2-0. But I mean, talking about the game that we were just in right there, they went with the Keeper of the Forest and the Pestilence and the Rally. I mean, what really went wrong with that? Why weren't they able to execute and really take down Denial with their Warby strategy?
Their draft started really strong. I was like, Keeper Ophelia, great heroes. And then they had Pestilence, Torture, great support, great initiator, a lot of damage. All they lack right now was the carry, but they picked Rally. So they didn't really have to follow up to the Pestilence stun. They already had an initiator, so like Pestilence Rally is kind of awkward in a way to get her. If that was a Sand Wraith, if that was a Wretched Hag, even a Carrier Bubbles of Grimoire Power, they would have had the damage and the follow-up following Pestilence, and they might have been in a better spot.
Yeah, I mean, talking about the Pestilence, you guys are one of the teams that's actually introduced Pestilence into the scene. Over there in TMSR, you love having either Slicks play the Pestilence. Most of the time, it's Slicks. And yes, you play him primarily as an initiator. Maybe he transitions into like a number two semi-carry later stages in the game. But here, it looked like Shit Happens was playing him as a primary carry, throwing him in the short lane and farming him, and you're just not too big of a fan of playing him in that role.
He's fine in the safe lane, but if you do that, you need a carry mid that can do well. For example, Hag. And if you... maybe instead of Rally, even Kraken would have been better. If you want a strength hero, if you want to survive the early game, you want a team fight, Kraken would be way better than Rally. But I'm guessing that it was banned. And I think the main problem of why they lost the game, why they didn't get enough out of the laning phase, was because when Empath and Magmas went long lane, Pestilence, Torture, and Ophelia should have punished that and killed them at least two times.
Yeah, unfortunately, they weren't able to really make any of those kills happen, and definitely started off pretty bad in the laning phase, weren't able to address Warbeast at all, and it just all kind of spiraled out of control from there. Yeah. So going into the next game, are they going to need to approach it a little bit differently with the draft? Is that starting with the bans, or where do they go from here?
The drafts, I think they need to approach it with... more of an emphasis on the mid lane, because when you don't contest mid lane and the enemy team has a Hag of Bubbles, they have supreme map control with the runes, because the Hag and Bubbles can be so mobile. They had the haste on Bubbles, which set up ganks. Hag was taking almost every single rune, DDs, and had their superb rune control. On top of that, when Ophelia went for a rune, Hag was there faster than him and resulted in killing the Ophelia. So you need to pick more rune control heroes if you do not contest middle. That came down to the solos from Denial beating the lanes because they take the runes from the bottles. And if, you know, when you buy a bottle, you snowball a lane of runes and you're definitely going to win your lane.
All right. Yeah. Well, guys, we're going to be getting into this one pretty soon here. Moon, before we do let you go, what are your feelings here on game two? Is Shit Happens going to be able to force a third and final, or does Denial take it 2-0 to advance to play you tomorrow?
My money is on Denial, if I would get bet on this, but my hopes are for BYOC, because I always want to see a Game 3.
There you go. Hoping for the underdogs, hoping for Game 3. Ladies and gentlemen, we are going to be getting into the next game here in just 1 second, so don't go anywhere. This is DreamHack winner 2013, Han, and we're going to be coming right back with Game 2 here. Shit Happens, fighting for their tournament lives. We'll see if Denial can close it out.